Dr. Jessie Sanders, owner and chief veterinarian of Aquatic Veterinary Services. Today on our Fish Facts series, we will be talking about parasites on fish. Now, this is just going to be a very general overview. I'm going to do a lot of separate videos looking at different individual parasites that our veterinary practice sees more commonly. So, what's kind of the deal with parasites, and how did you end up with them in your system, and how do they end up taking over everything and killing all your fish? Well, first of all, to start out, most fish already have parasites on them. Kind of just comes from living in an aquatic environment. Just like we have bacteria and tiny bugs on us, fish are the same way. Now, their immune system, as long as it's working correctly, keeps all those parasites from replicating. But you get a fish that is stressed out, say from poor water chemistry, our number one favorite topic. Unfortunately, that causes their immune system to kind of let those parasites slide a little, and suddenly they're replicating faster and faster and overwhelming your system. So for the most part, a fish with a healthy immune system, again, you're gonna see parasites occasionally. And as a veterinarian, we see them all the time. And it's up to us to really determine, okay, is this a level that this fish can handle? You know, there's one, two per the slide, or is it just overrun with hundreds and hundreds of parasites? So it makes a big difference if you're doing those clips and smears to really kind of understand what you're looking at and taking into consideration the entire environment of a fish. Now there's a lot of different parasites, and they're usually divided between the freshwater and the saltwater. No matter what kind of fish you are, unfortunately, parasites are always going to try to get you no matter what species you are. But they tend to stick to saltwater and freshwater. And there's many, many different species. They all have different life cycles, and treatment for them is going to vary quite significantly. So the most common clinical signs that your fish has a parasite infestation is flashing. Now, this is a behavior where you see your fish swimming along, and then it will kind of make a pancake dip on the bottom of, or the sides of your tank or your pond. And this is essentially a fish trying to scratch themselves because they don't have nails or toe claws like your cat and dog does. So that's kind of the one clinical sign that you see, but you can also see lethargy, increased respiratory effort, and even sudden death. So any of these signs, your fish might be sick. Obviously, you want to get into a vet right away. Now, most parasites are microscopic, which means you're not going to see them with your naked eye. There are a few macroscopic ones, such as Argillus and Lernia, your anchorworms and lice. Now, a lot of the times, parasites get into fish systems because your fish are not properly quarantined. And we have a separate video illustrating how parasites can run amok, starring me as all four little fish. There's a link below in the description of this video. But essentially, when a fish is going through quarantine, they're being kept separate because the stress of being captured in wherever they're being kept, put in a little plastic bag and thrown in your car and drone wherever, is the same as an alien abduction. And it's stressful. And depending on how long it lasts, you know, you're throwing them into a completely novel environment with new fish, new environment, that could last for a while. And again, that enters that chronic stress situation where their immune system starts to drop. And whatever decided to tag along from the fish store, the vendor, is gonna spread to everyone in the tank. So our most common cause of parasites is you added a new fish within the last couple weeks. And a lot of times you don't think about that because, you know, you're thinking bacteria and viruses, but parasites are actually the number one kind of issue that we see with new fish being added to an environment. So if you are concerned or think your fish might have a parasite, yes, I understand there are lots of parasite medications that are available on the shelves. Do any of them list their ingredients? Maybe about 10% do. And if so, is that even a therapeutic level? So please contact your veterinarian. They will do all the diagnostics, know exactly what parasite you have, and be able to prescribe an effective and quick treatment so you can save all of your other little fish. So no matter freshwater, saltwater, there's gonna be parasites looking out for your fish. So make sure that you take proper care of them and provide them with good quarantine for any new fish entering your environment. So that's kind of the general parasite overview. Like I said, we'll be doing more videos about the individual parasites, just from what we see more commonly in our veterinary practice. But thank you so much for watching. If you have any other questions, please visit our website at cafishvet.com. At Aquatic Veterinary Services, fish are treated like family.